night, it finally came, my care package from 343, and I can't wait to... Psych! What's up, everybody? Tazman here from the Bad at Halo show. Just wanted to do a quick commentary video here on the HCS playlist and just my thoughts and feelings and, I don't know, fears maybe about what this means for the casual community moving forward in Halo 5. So first and foremost, as you're watching some of my really crappy gameplay in the HCS playlist, I just wanted to say first and foremost that I'm really glad that this playlist finally exists. I mean, it's been in Halo for as long as there's been competitive Halo. There's always been a playlist dedicated to the super competitive community. And I'm really happy for them and happy for some of my friends who lean towards the competitive route. Finally have a playlist that incorporates their direct feedback and something that they can really be excited about and something that they can have as their own. So that's awesome. And I'm really happy for them. A really strong competitive community does nothing but help the game grow, and that is awesome. Unfortunately, I just have this little bit of doubt in the pit of my stomach, and I talked about it a little bit on my last podcast, and I'll talk a little bit about it here as well. For months and months and months, all I ever heard on Twitter from competitive and pro players was that they just wanted a playlist that was all their own. They just wanted a list that directly incorporated their feedback to change the settings to the settings that they felt highlighted the best in Halo skill, and they've got that. And I was hoping that when that finally dropped for them, that they would be happy and all would be fine in the Halo world. And then you start getting rumblings and rumors about the HCS playlist being incorporated into ranked Team Arena, ranked Slayer, Free For All, etc., etc. That concerns me. And it concerns me because a small portion of the Halo community is trying to dictate the gameplay mechanics for the player base at large. That's not a good thing. And here's where I start to think that these types of moves are just proof that that particular player base and 343 are starting to push casual gamers out of Halo 5. So, where do I get this crazy thought from? Well, let's take a look at the multiplayer settings that are currently out there and available. So you've got this HCS preview list, which hopefully just turns into the HCS playlist, and it just kind of keeps on going. This HCS playlist is extremely unfriendly to the casual player because it's not meant for the casual player. It's not meant for me to go in and have fun and enjoy myself. It is meant for people to go in, get their sweaty tryhard pants on, and go out and try to destroy people and make a name for themselves out in matchmaking. Fine. That's great. And what are the casual gamers always told? They talk about getting outmatched and outwitted and just completely stomped in ranked games. We're told to go to social. Well, that would be just fine with me if social was indeed social. It's not. It's not even close. I've talked about this plenty of times on my podcast, and I'll explain it here as well, that social is only social for elite players. The fact that you take away ranks from the playlist doesn't in and of itself make it social. There is a lot more behind a social casual gamer than just rank. But we have this matchmaking system, and I guess we might as well not even call it a matchmaking system, where anybody can face off against anybody. So your champ and Onyx level players can go into social, match up against a team of bronze and silvers, and just start pub stomping people. I mean, how is that supposed to be fun? How can a casual gamer who just wants to go in, play some games with some buddies, have some fun, win some, lose some, doesn't really matter, so long as everybody had a good time, that's really all that matters. How can we do that when we're constantly being matched against teams of Onyx and champion ranked players who are looking to warm up their shot or just kick some lesser skilled players around or get their montage clips, what have you? The social playlist is yet another playlist that's completely and totally catered to elite players. The rest of us in that playlist were just fodder for them. So what does that leave us with? Well, that leaves us with your standard run-of-the-mill ranked lists that have been in Halo 5 since it launched. Team Arena, Slayer, Free-for-All, SWAT, etc. Right now, those are the only lists that are in any way, shape, or form actually friendly to casual players. I mean, think about it. The matchmaking criteria in those playlists is much closer towards your skill. So you're, as a casual player, you're far more likely to pull in another casual player on the other end. Sure, it can be a little bit more competitive than some of us would like for a casual playlist, but it suits the bill fine, at least a hell of a lot better than Social Team Skirmish does. So if you start incorporating super sweaty competitive settings into that playlist, now that playlist also becomes unfriendly to the casual gamer. That's where the casual side is really getting this idea that we're being pushed out, that we don't matter. That, hey, thanks for playing the last year and a half, but we're going to move our focus on to the elite players because even though they're small, they're the most vocal, and so we need to do what's right by them because, you know, they have fans and followings. HCS brings in money, all that stuff. Whereas the casual gamers, well, you guys are just fans. Now again, this is probably not at all the mentality of 343 and the people that are making this decisions for these lists, but that's just how I feel personally as a casual gamer, that I'm slowly being pushed out of the game, and oh hey, I hope you come back for Halo 6. Maybe I'm just being crazy, maybe I'm just being paranoid, but I'm interested to hear what you guys have to say, so leave some comments down below. You know, tell me what you think. Are you a casual gamer? Do you feel like you're being pushed out? Are you a competitive player? Do you feel like we're being pushed out and you guys are kind of being the new favorite child from 343? Or why aren't the casual gamers being pushed out? What's being put in place that keeps casual gamers in place that maybe I'm not seeing? And don't bring up Firefight. I mean, let's be honest. We all love Firefight, right? But there's something just a little bit more satisfying, even to a casual gamer, about going up against somebody one-on-one and coming out ahead in a gunfight that you just don't get with Firefight. But anyway, guys, let me know what you think. If you like this video, be sure to hit the like button and please share the video. I'd really like to see some discussion out there, both from the competitive and the casual side. Are casual gamers being pushed out? And what can we do to kind of keep both sides happy? Because as much as we need a happy and flourishing competitive community, we need a happy and flourishing casual side of Halo as well, and that's what will make the Halo world go round again. So until then, my Spartan is dead. I'll catch you guys on my next respawn, and until then, and as always, don't be like me. Finish your games with a positive KD.